Hello and welcome. In this tutorial, we'll be discussing about isometric tilemaps in Unity. So let's look at the example. We are going to be using the asset tile pack that I downloaded from Open Game Art. I'll post the link of this art in the description below. I'll start first by creating the palette. So the way to create the palette is by going to Window, 2D and Tile Palette. I'll dock this tile palette to the right hand side. We'll be needing this tile palette if we want to draw anything in our scene. I'll first create a new palette. I'll be using an isometric tile here, so I'll name the palette to be Isometric Tile Palette. I'll change the grid from rectangle to isometric. So we have two options here, isometric and the isometric ZSY. So what this isometric ZSY does is, it allows you to add an offset to the y-axis of each tile that you paint onto the scene. Set the cell size to automatic and click on create. Okay, so now it's basically asking me to create a palette asset file here. I'll click the assets folder and click choose. If I just pull this up a little bit, you will see a Z position value here. This Z position value is going to be extremely useful in the time to come, as you will see later. Now it's asking me to drag a file, sprite or sprite texture asset into this. I have this grass asset. If I look at its texture, I have set it to Sprite 2D and UI and I have changed its pixel per unit so that it tightly fits the cell, and I have changed the filter mode to point because I don't want it to blur. Now I'll drag and drop this grass asset onto this slot in the tile palette. So Unity is basically telling me that it's going to create a tile file for me. So I'll click on save. Now before using the brush tool in order to draw this, I need to have an isometric game object component. So to create it, I go to game object, 2D object and select isometric tilemap. So immediately you see a grid that has appeared onto my hierarchy. Now I'll select the tile, click on paint and start drawing in the scene. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to add some snow on top of this grass. So I have this snow asset, I'll drag and drop it to this palette and once again I'll create the tile asset file. I'll select the snow and start painting. But if you look at it closely, you will see that the snow is overlapping or it's on top of this grass. I want them to be on the same level with the grass. So this happens in Unity because of two reasons. First of all, you need to go to the grid game object and select the tile map. And if you scroll down a little bit, you will see the mode set to chunk. Now, as per Unity documentation, the chunk mode is best when you are building the Unity game. But if you are inside the Unity editor or if you are debugging the game, you need to set it to the other mode, that is the individual mode. Now if I zoom it out a little bit, you will see that this does not really solve our problem. Now why this happens is the reason number two, that Unity renders everything in 3D mode. So the camera basically looks at the object. Suppose we have two objects, one is closer to the camera or it's lower, and one is far away from the camera. So what Unity does is, it will render those components that are closer to the camera first. So the one that is closer to the camera appears more than the one that is farther away from the camera. Now this is called taking depth into perspective. This is not how the 2D works. We have the x-axis that goes horizontally and the y-axis that goes up and down. So to fix this in Unity is pretty easy. You just need to go to Edit, Project Settings. So here you have to change the sort mode from default to a custom axis. Now here you don't want to take the x-axis into consideration. But yes, you do want to take the y-axis into consideration, so you change it to a 1 and you can keep the z-axis to 0. We don't want to take the z-axis into consideration. Now why have set this x to 0, y to 1 and z to 0? That is because I want to tell the Unity game engine that whatever comes on the top or what is further away from the camera should be rendered first. Now you see that the snow is on the same level that of the grass. So if I draw it again, you will see that it overrides the grass. But the question now becomes, you don't want to create a flat looking level. You want to add some objects like trees or some objects that have a little elevation while being in the scene. So what I'll do is, I'll change the Z position to a 1. And now if I draw it, you will see that it doesn't draw on top of the grass, but it draws to the sides. So it kind of tries to override the grass, but it's not able to do so. Now the reason why this is happening is that we have set the Unity transparent layer order to simply not take the z-axis into consideration. But in the future, we are telling Unity to take the z-axis into account. So it's kind of getting confused whether you're going to use the z-axis value or not. So we once again go to Edit, Project Settings and change the z value a little bit. Now the best value that works here is a -0.49. It's kind of a static value, but actually it's not a static value. We are telling Unity to take the z-axis into consideration. Now you close the window. Now even this does not solve the issue for me. So if we go to our grid game object and look at the cell size, it is the volume that the cell occupies. The x value here is set to 1, which is good. The y value is set to a 0.5, that is also very good. But here, the z value is not being taken into consideration. So we're basically going to increase the z value. Now the snow looks a little bit elevated than that of the grass. So the z value might change according to the assets that you're using in your project. Now suppose I don't want this snow to appear at this height, or I want to erase this elevated snow. So I'll select the brush tool. So one quick thing to mention here is that if you have set the z position of the snow to be 1 when you're painting, then you need to have a z position of 1 when you're erasing it, or else it is not just going to read that level. So I'll just keep it 1 and start rubbing it. All the snow that was on layer 1 is now getting erased. You can also set this to a minus value. So if you don't want to change anything that's been painted on the 0 level, and if you want to paint something on the level below it, then you can change this to -1. Use the brush tool. And now if I paint it, you will see that the snow appears below that of the grass and others on the scene. So I hope you understood about the isometric tilemap in Unity.